up to now, the result from match, that number is not very useful. So mostly matches means it succeeds or it fails. So we have that information, but that's not enough for what we want. So we are going to see captures now, that it's ways to extract information for what is being matched. So the first capture is the simple capture, it's a C. It means just grab the string that matches that pattern inside the C. For instance, let's start with an example. For instance, here I can match any number of A's, for instance. It's a little artificial, but let's see that. And then I want to capture whatever character that comes after that many A's. So that means zero or more A's followed by one character, but that one character is being captured by LPeg.c. So if I match that against A, B, C, D, for instance, then the result is exactly what was captured by this pattern here. Again, like operators, C converts its arguments applying P. So I can write that simply like that. The one here means LPeg.p1. So C converts its argument applying P. So I can, if I put a string here, it means a literal string. If I put a number, it means that many characters. So this is a simple capture. The same pattern has more than one capture. So for instance, I can have that. And then I skip three characters. Let's skip two characters. And then I capture the next two captures here. Now, if I match that against those A's will be escaped, then I have an X, and then I have two characters that will be skipped by these two here, and then the next two characters. So remember, in Lua we have multiple returns, and so the match returns all captures made by the match. So for instance, here we have the X and we have another result with the BC that was captured here. So this is very, very important in LPeg. We will see that we more often than not we capture several different things in a single match. And one thing that is very important also is that the number of captures can be variable. So consider this example here, that they look the same. I'll give two examples here. They look the same, but they are quite different. Let's put a capture here. So I have a capture A repeated zero or more times. So what we have here, we have the capture is being repeated. So if I match that against AAAA, notice that we have four results, one for each time that this capture matches. And we can have something that looks quite similar, that is A 0, but this time the repetition is inside the capture. So unlike the other one, sorry, don't need that many parentheses. So unlike the other one, here I have one single capture of as many A's as happen to match here inside. So here if I match A, I have one single capture with that. And the same happens with optional stuff. For instance, if I have lpeg.p.capture one character, no, let's put an A here as an example, of minus one, that means an optional capture. So if I match A, it succeeds. If I have B, it matches nothing. And when there is no matches, then we have that old return of the last character, the first character after the match. So we have the one here means that there was no other captures here, because exactly this capture here is optional. So what happens here is that it didn't match. And on the other hand, I can have something like this is more or less similar to the repetition case, whereas the optional stuff, it's inside the capture. So in this case, I always have one capture, but what is being captured can be the A or the empty string if there are no ways to match this pattern here. Another very useful capture is what we call a position capture that is created by CP, that it matches the current position in the subject. So for instance, I may want to match, let's say, any number of A's, and then I may want to capture what's the current position, and then match B here. So if I match A, B, we need here a repetition. So I want zero or more A's, followed by get the current position, and then matches a B. So if I match here, I have four that was, I matched here, 1, 2, 3. So I am at current position is 4 now before I match B. So this example also shows us that captures don't need to be only strings. They can be numbers, and as we will see later, then can be any kind of value in Lua. We will have tables as captures, we can have even functions as the result of captures. We'll see later that we can use any kind of value in Lua as the result of a capture.